the Mountaineers and the Longhorns from the Frank Irwin Center in Austin. Alongside a former MOP in the Final Four, Miles Simon, I'm Rich Hollenberg. And Miles, these Mountaineers had a 21-point win over then number one Baylor this past Tuesday. So why is today's game against Texas so important for the Mountaineers?
Because the best teams in the country always have consistency. So you want to have no letdown today against a Texas team that's already missing its leading scorer in Tevin Mack. The way they beat the number one team in the country, they forced 29 turnovers, took Baylor out of everything that they wanted to do.
You mentioned Tevin Mack sitting out the game. He was suspended indefinitely by Shaka Smart's club. Violation of team rules, no timetable for his return. He was the top scorer for the Longhorns, so who steps in or steps up for Shaka Smart?
Well, in this game in particular, it has to be the guard. Duke Roach, Andrew Jones, and Eric Davis Jr., they're going to have the ball in their hands a ton. It's a young backcourt, no true point guard. You have to take care of the ball against this fresh Virginia team.
Eric Davis, number 10 for the Longhorns, gets the start instead of Mack, and he controls the opening tip. Your officials this afternoon, Gary Maxwell, Paul Jansen, and Don Daly.
Now it's of utmost importance for this young Texas team to get off to a good start, especially on the offensive end of the floor.
It is not a good shooting Longhorns team. They're short on their first shot, and the rebound goes to Brandon Watkins. Here comes Press Virginia, ranked number 10th in the nation, coming in at 14-2 and 3-1 in the Big 12. Here's Ahmad, leading scorer for the Mountaineers, 5 on the shot clock. Javon Carter leaves it up, Clara picks it off.
What an excellent possession defensively for this Longhorn team. Moved their feet, read the plays, took away every option of the Mountaineers.
It's Jared Allen, number 31 in white, the number one center out of high school this past year.
Claire's been good in the post, loves to go over that left shoulder.
Shaq Claire opens the scoring.
Shaka Smart talked to us about, in shoot-around today, about Shaq Claire having to demand the basketball a little bit more.
Inside to the senior captain, number 11 in blue, that's Nathan Adrian, had a career night against Baylor. And he gets off to a hot start here.
Well, great pick and pop action there. Patience on the offensive end. Carter hits Adrian on the pop back. Adrian been struggling from the three-point arc so far this season. 40% last year, but only 23% coming into today's game.
And him hitting his first shot's a good sign for Bob Huggins, who said he struggled with the stomach flu all week.
And you see, as soon as that ball goes through the hoop, it's full court pressure by West Virginia. And they're able to cause the turnover on the jump ball.
Bob Huggins, he of the 805 career wins, number 3 all-time among active coaches. A win today, Miles, and he ties Hall of Famer Eddie Sutton for 9th all-time on that list.
Well, he's one of the best to ever do it, and you know, his players, as hard as he is on them in practice every day, he's a great teacher of this game. He said he especially loves being around this group because they're hardworking. They bring great energy and effort to practice every day.
Senior working on a freshman. Adrian, tough shot, offensive rebound. And that's another one of Adrian's specialties. He's one of the tops in the Big 12 in offensive boards.
Well, right there, he does the little step through. Allen gets out of position. And that's something Coach Darren Horn worked on with his big guys yesterday in the post. Once you stop that first drives, continue to stay down on the floor and move your feet.
Nathan Adrian, a 6'9", 235-pound senior. Hometown kid, played his high school ball in Morgantown and now finishing up a special career with Bob Huggins at West Virginia. And you talk about the hallmarks of a good coach, Miles, developing players. He's case in point. Nathan Adrian's gotten better every year he's played.
Yeah, he really has, and he's really kind of waited his time. And you know, with the Press Virginia style, you're gonna find opportunities to get on the court because of how they press you for 40 minutes.
Here's the freshman Andrew Jones, number 1 in white. He'll have his hands full all afternoon. What's the best way to handle this press?
Well, you want to beat it by the pass, or if there's a double team, you can try to split the double team and make a third guy play you.
Allen, nice touch from the freshman. Jared Allen with his first two.
Allen, the number one center in high school basketball last season, committed late in the process, late May, to be a Texas Longhorn. instant impact guy.
There's Daxter Miles Jr., too strong on the three, and the rebound goes to the freshman Allen.
And look, even after misses, you have to be aware. Someone has to come back to the basketball.
Kerwin Roach going in the wrong direction, gets backed all the way up to his baseline. It'll stay Texas ball.
But right now, Texas has to realize someone should be pointing out there's only 4 seconds to get it across. And I don't know if they're aware that the 10-second count does not reset.
Shaka Smart just shouted that exact point to his troops on the floor. They have to hurry it up. And they do just get it across. Here's Jones for three.
Excellent recognition. Good job by Shaka Smart to let his young Longhorn team know that they had to rush it across. And then a real confidence booster there for Andrew Jones.
Nearly 7-4 Texas lead. Jones coming off the night. We're at 8 points, 5 assists, and only 2 turnovers in the loss to TCU. Miles tries again from beyond the arc. He's 0 for 2. Big offensive board by Ahmad, and Issa Ahmad will go to the line.
Watch this, Texas from the inbound. A great inbound play there. Allen gets it right back to the inbounder. Davis just 2 dribbles, draws the double team, and then the wide open Andrew Jones for the 3-point make.
Something that Shaka Smart was telling us at practice yesterday. How do you attack West Virginia's pressure? You attack it with aggressiveness, and we saw it right there. Number 3 checking in for Shaka Smart. That's Jacob Young, another freshman guard out of Houston, Texas. And Sagaba Kanate, a 6'8 freshman from Mali, checking in for Bob Huggins' club. They're high on him, looking to get him some more minutes.
Yeah, Kanate really a game changer for this team in the protection spot against this press, because he's the best shot blocker for the Mountaineers.
And there's a turnover. Let's see if West Virginia turns it into points. They do, and have a chance at a 3-point play. And that's been the biggest difference for West Virginia this year with their press.
Rich, that's what they're so good at. You get Andrew Jones out of control right there, making a poor pass once he breaks the press. The deflections, the hands by Ahmad. Ahmad gets his eyes up. And then Daxter Miles pushing in transition. The long steps, the contact. That is where they have really excelled, as you said, finishing off of those turnovers.
Miles completes the 3-point play. And there's Nathan Adrian, the head of the snake, if you will, on this West Virginia press. Five seconds to get it across half court. And Eric Davis does. And a whistle, a foul going to be called on West Virginia. That foul's going to go on Nathan Adrian. 16:10 to go.
Well, you watch now in the half court defensively, West Virginia. They try to full deny all over the court. Offensive foul there on Banks on the clear out.
That counts as another turnover. That'll be the third Longhorns turnover in the first 4 minutes of the game.
Now, the one difference in that turnover, I know, is an offensive foul, but it wasn't a live ball turnover. No chance for West Virginia to get out in transition.
Nathan Adrian to the bench. Number 25, Machi Bender, checking in. A 6'10 freshman out of Poland, seeing his first action. From Austin, Texas, and the Irwin Event Center, welcome in if you're just joining us on ESPN2. West Virginia, ranked number 10 in the country, with an early 8-7 lead against the Texas Longhorns. West Virginia coming off that resounding 21-point blowout win at home against the number 1 team in the country on Tuesday, the Baylor Bears. Miles Simon alongside me, Rich Hollenberg. Glad you're with us on a Saturday afternoon. Big 12 basketball. So these Mountaineers win by 21 against the top-ranked team in the country. Why is today's game so important for Bob Huggins' club?
Well, the best teams in the country, what you look for in them is consistency. And so if you're West Virginia, you have this huge win at home against the number 1 team in the country. Now, a Texas team that has lost their leading scorer due to suspension. you want to look to not have any type of letdown going into today's game and play with that same high level intensity that you did on Tuesday night.
There's Shaka Smart, second year in Austin, eighth overall as a head coach, despite just being 39 years old. His Horns are 7-9 coming in this season, have really struggled, but they are talented. They got a lot of top 50 talent. Three of their four Big 12 games, Miles, have been sided by 3 points. Unfortunately, they're 1-2 of those games and 1-3 overall in the conference.
Yeah, well, one of the biggest problems right now for this Texas team is their youth and the fact that they don't have a true point guard on this roster. They're kind of having to do it by committee. Andrew Jones, Kerwin Roach, those guys taking over their duties, even Eric Davis at times. And then earlier this week, your leading scorer, Tevin Mack, the sophomore, 15 points per game, he's suspended indefinitely.
Tevin Mack suspended yesterday. It was announced by the school. We talked to Shaka Smart about it. He said violation of team rules, no timetable for Tevin Mack's return. And as you mentioned, he's the top scorer on this team. And really, even though he's only a sophomore, Tevin Mack's one of the veterans of this young Lone Horns team. They're really going to miss him. So who steps up in his stead?
Well, I think in this game in particular, it has to be the guards. It has to be Kerwin Roach, Andrew Jones, Eric Davis Jr., because they're going to see so much pressure from this West Virginia team for the 40 minutes of this game. And this is a team that has had trouble turning the ball over all season long. They have a negative assist to turnover ratio. So can those three guards get it together today, play fundamentally sound, take care of the ball, and along with that, run the offense, get the big guy involved, a lot of duties, and defend on the other end of the floor. A lot of responsibility falling on this young Longhorn backcourt.
Sounds like an awfully big ask for these young Texas Longhorns. But if anybody can turn it around, it's certainly Shaka Smart. He leads by positivity and enthusiasm. And we were commenting when we watched them practice yesterday and this morning, you wouldn't know that this team is two games under 500 and two games under 500 in conference play by watching them on the floor.
Yeah, the energy that they have brought to practice each and every day, even the shoot around this morning, they're ready to go against a very tough West Virginia team.
Already the sixth team foul called on the Longhorns. And now we're seeing the first action of Mareek Isom, number 14 in white, a graduate transfer from Little Rock. First time he's on the floor this season for Shaka Smart's club. Here's the big man Bender. Baseline short.
You see, that's not a good shot by Bender because he's wide open on the skip pass. You pump fake yourself out of a good shot into a contested 15-footer. Take the first one. I saw him knocking down three-point shots in shoot-around today.
Roach calls his own number. He misses, and Kanate clears for West Virginia. When the Mountaineers are in their half-court offense, what do they like to do?
Well, it depends on what the set is. One, they don't want to turn it over. First of all. But they'll get into their five-out motion at times, depending on the players that are on the floor. But they also like to run a little triangle offense from the high post and two guys at the block kind of interchanging. You'll see that multiple times tonight.
Well, Bob Huggins told us earlier today he went to his first National Hockey League game when the Pittsburgh Penguins won the Stanley Cup. He just had a line change. Three Mountaineers checking in for him. This is a deep team. They play at least 11 guys.
But I like this second group that he brings in because Phillip, Tavon Myers, Kanate, so much energy off the bench, and they're all really, really good defenders.
That's going to be a foul on Issa Ahmad. He's the leading scorer for this Mountaineers club, averaging 12.6 a game. A balanced scoring team, four players in double figures for Bob Huggins' club. And you mentioned you like that second unit. 39 points a game off the bench for the Mountaineers.
Right now, I want to get Jared Allen a touch on the block against Nathan Adrian. Adrian doing a good job of fronting and moving his feet.
And there's a nice stroke from the outside.
That's so big for Eric Davis because his confidence has been down. He hasn't shot the three ball well. He started the season 6-for-41 in his first 8 games, and he just hasn't been able to recover yet.
He might be an X factor against these Mountaineers. Had 15 against them in last year's win. It's Texas swept West Virginia last year. There's a nice take from number 12 in navy blue. That's Tariq Phillips' first two of the game.
Yeah, but that was a completely different Texas team led by Isaiah Taylor and Javon Felix, Connor Lambert, guys that could really handle the press. And look at the big fella handling the press right there, Jared Allen.
Allen got fouled, and he'll go to the line and shoot two. Jared Allen shooting 56% from the field, averaging close to a double-double, 11 points, almost 8 rebounds a game. And the good sign for him going to the line, he's only a 55% free throw shooter, Miles, but he's hit 9 of his last 11 from the stripe.
Well, Shaka Smart had so many great things to say about Jared Allen. He's kind of an introverted guy, but he's very smart, takes in everything that the coaching staff is bringing to him on a daily basis, trying to apply that. He's kind of having to learn a different position in high school and AAU because he was the biggest, most athletic guy, obviously one of the best players out there. He played the five spot, but with Shaq Clair here, he has to roam around the perimeter a little bit more, get a little bit more comfortable handling the basketball, making plays, passing.
There's Shaq Clair, one of the lone seniors on Shaka Smart's bench. And with the lane violation a moment ago, Jared Allen will have another shot at knocking down two free throws. A career-high 18 last time out against TCU. And he only had two turnovers in that game, Miles, and that's another good sign.
Now you see light pressure from Texas, a little 1-2-1-1. Try to throw West Virginia off.
Matching aggression with aggression. Right now they're leading by two.
And now they drop back into the zone for the first time. Back to man-to-man.
Myers gets it inside to Adrian, but we have an offensive foul.
Well, right now, if you're Shaka Smart, you have to love the intensity and the toughness that your team is playing with.
And that's two on Nathan Adrian, and the veteran for West Virginia knows immediately that he's going to take a seat on the bench.
But almost for West Virginia, it's really... it's no drop-off. So you lose Nathan Adrian coming off a career high, but you bring in Issa Ahmad, your leading scorer.
And now Lamont West is at the head of the press, number 15, a redshirt freshman out of Cincinnati. Six and a half gone by. Texas hanging with number 10, West Virginia. Allen gets a fresh 30 on the offensive board. Roach way off the mark. Phillip? No, Macon can't handle the offensive rebound. It goes out of bounds. It'll be Texas basketball. Get it into Allen. Allen gets it back to Davis. And Paul Jansen says Jacob Young stepped on the baseline.
But you know what I love? Shaka Smart not worried about the turnover. He told Jacob Young, you should have shot that basketball. Shoot it on the catch and shoot three. I love the positivity of that. Turns a negative into a positive for this young man.
Fourth turnover for these young Longhorns. Spin move, Ahmad. Nope. Don Daly says no shot. Fouls on the floor.
See, now this is one of the things that college basketball really needs to improve on. That's a continuation right there because Issa Ahmad, he wasn't doing anything but going to shoot the basketball. When he went into the spin, and he's going to get a one-on-one, but that should be a two-shot opportunity, and I don't think college basketball does that well enough in giving guys continuation opportunities.
I know it might be hard to believe, but we have just under 13 minutes to go, and already West Virginia is shooting free throws on every subsequent Texas foul. Tomorrow night, we have the 15th annual Martin Luther King Jr. celebration as the Grizzlies play host to Jimmy Butler and the Bulls. That's at 9 Eastern on ESPN. The Grizz coming off a nice 5-point win over Houston. Zebo coming off the bench.
I like the Grizzlies team. Yeah. Mike Conley, big money man. But David Fizdale, the former assistant for Miami Heat, doing an excellent job in his first year there. That team just now really getting healthy. Gasol missed some games. Chandler Parsons had been out. Conley missed games.
Tony Allen finally found a use in that game, too.
Tony Allen's amazing. Tony Allen would be great in press Virginia, wouldn't he?
Yeah.
God, he would be awesome. Oh, he is such a tenacious defender.
They are in your face all the time. We have much more coming up
on
West Virginia. What makes this press so difficult to play against?
Well, that's great rotation there by Elijah Macon. Perfect job on the defensive end. He comes over to the help right away, sets his feet. Jaren Allen has to catch that. He was already knew that he was going to put the ball on the floor, but you got to catch, read the defense, then go.
So Tariq Philippe, number 12 in blue, bringing it up for Bob Huggins Mountaineers. And Texas forces a turnover, giving the Mountaineers a taste of their own medicine. Here's Jones. Young attacks. Can't get it to go, but gets the foul drawn. He was listening to his head coach. And now you see just how young these Longhorns are. Three freshmen on the floor right now. Kerwin Roach is just a sophomore. Make that four freshmen with James Banks on the floor as well. If you're as old as I am, you remember Jacob Young's dad, Michael, playing for that famed Phi Slamma-Jamma class from University of Houston, and Guy Lewis went to back-to-back NCAA championship games.
Yeah, playing with Clyde Drexler, Hakeem Olajuwon before he had the H. I mean, before he had the H in his name.
Young knocks it down. A 14-12 Texas lead, low scoring in the early going, coming up on 12 minutes to go. Miles measures it, can't hit, he's 0 for 3 from deep today. Ball goes out of bounds, and we have a timeout on the floor with Texas leading West Virginia 14-12. And when we come back, Miles Simon invading my personal space, but it's for a good reason. We'll explain how it ties in to Press Virginia when we come back. Well, if you're wondering what it's like in real life to face the relentless pressure of West Virginia's defense, so was I. And boy, am I sorry I asked. I give up.
This is what it's like to face West Virginia every game.
I had no time to prepare for this game because Miles was up in my business the entire time.
Well, to play against West Virginia is arguably one of the most annoying things in college basketball because it's relentless, it's nonstop, it's for 40 minutes, and I know they don't press every possession, but when you get in the half court, they're still in your face, they're still in your grill when you catch the ball, they deny you the basketball, they make you so uncomfortable the whole time you're out there on the basketball, kind of like what I was doing to you.
Right now, this Texas Longhorn team, I'm impressed. They came out with tremendous energy today. Their effort has been phenomenal. They're taking care of the basketball, making West Virginia work for everything they got.
Miles hasn't found the mark yet from beyond the arc. And here come the Longhorns. They're trying to outpress Press Virginia right now. 9-6 in terms of points off turnovers for Texas. It's a big reason they're up by two. Side. Banks. No shot, and he traveled. That's turnover number 6 for the Longhorns.
Yeah, but about 3 or 4 of those turnovers have been dead ball turnovers, so that really allows Texas to get back and set up their half-court defense.
West Virginia has not scored in about 3 minutes. What's Texas doing defensively that's impressed you?
Well, they're making them work. They've mixed up their defenses. They've gone from the man-to-man to the zone. They've kept them off the offensive glass on the misses.
Okay. 10 on the shot clock. Miles, not being shy, but he's still shooting over.
Well, he's had great looks, and he just can't knock them down. Best three-point shooter on the team.
Here's Isom. His first shot of the season is off the mark. He's a three-point marksman. They're hoping he can give him some quality minutes, especially now with Tevin Mack suspended. Shot by West, too strong.
Not a good look. They're hanging too much on the perimeter. Got to get the basketball on the inside. That's West Virginia's strength.
Transition three, Jones off the mark. And West clears on the weak side.
If you're West Virginia, you're in the bonus. Try to attack the rim. Draw some more fouls against this Texas team.
It's a great point. They've missed their last six shots, and they've all been jump shots. Tip ball, deflection, and there's a foul on the play. Well, it's pretty simple math when you look at the 14 wins versus the two losses for the Mountaineers.
Yeah, well, you can see what they do. The turnovers are down. Opponents' points off turnovers go up to about 20 per game. But the biggest, really, the telling factor in the two losses is also the deflections. And right now, Texas is taking care of that basketball. Only about 35 deflections per game in the losses. Over 50 in the wins for West Virginia.
I asked Bob Huggins that exact question this week. Do you have a number that you put on your deflections? He said, if we're over 40, we're good. If we're under 40, we're not very good. 40 is a big number. We saw Louisville take down Duke earlier today. Rick Pitino targets 35 deflections a game.
Well, what the deflections let you know if you're active on the defensive end and if you're alert and you're engaged.
West Virginia seems a little out of sync offensively.
Well, they were just trying to overload against this zone. Look, they got four, trying to get four against three.
10 to shoot.
No penetrating passes, no penetrating dribbles.
And we're going the other way. This is an engaged, inspired bunch of Longhorns right now going against number 10 West Virginia, coming off that win at home in Morgantown against number one Baylor. Bob Huggins getting win number 805, and it was one of the biggest ones of the year, certainly taking down the top-ranked team and in conference nonetheless.
Well, we talked about it in the open that you don't want to have a letdown. Right now, I'm not seeing – I was at the game on Tuesday, the Baylor game. I saw tremendous energy, effort, talking on the floor the whole 40 minutes. I haven't seen that in the first 10 minutes here from West Virginia.
Nice big-to-big passing. Allen to Claire for the easy two. A four-point Longhorns lead. Inside out, here's Myers. Nice look. And Bender has his first two of the game. That was West Virginia's first bucket since the 14-18 mark. Almost 6 minutes of game time has passed. Today, Kansas held off Oklahoma State at home in Fog Allen Fieldhouse as we see Jared Allen go from the other side of the block.
Well, the thing that most impressed me right there, you see the skill. The flash, he presented himself, those long arms, gave a target, and then the finish with the left hand, even more impressive.
Biggest lead of the game right now for the young Longhorns. Five on the shot clock for West Virginia. Carter forced it up, and Roach comes away with the rebound. And immediately they go on the break. Here's Jones. Yes! Largest lead of the game for the Texas Longhorns, 21-14.
Well, the Longhorns getting out and running, showing those young legs, and Andrew Jones with the great three-point stroke. Longhorns up seven.
Back in Austin, Texas, Big 12 basketball on a Saturday afternoon. Rich Hollenberg, Miles Simon, the rest of the ESPN2 crew, and you look at the numbers strictly and you say, wow, Texas is really struggling. 7-9 this year, 1-3 in the Big 12, but three of their four Big 12 games have been decided by 3 points, and right now we're seeing a very upbeat, energized Texas Longhorns team.
Yeah, they're really playing tremendous basketball, and now switching the defense once again to a 1-3-1, and you have Jared Allen, the longest guy on the floor, up front.
Carter, no. Fresh 30 for the Mountaineers.
And here's where West Virginia struggles and where they can be beat. When you make West Virginia a half-court team that has to execute for a majority of the game as they are right now throughout this first half, it's where they really struggle.
Jones. He has 2 3-pointers on the day, not now. How about West Virginia just 1 for 9 from beyond the arc? Myers changes that.
But look how much faster they played there. They get the defensive rebound, they push in transition. Myers runs to the deep corner and knocks it down.
His teammates call him the heart and soul of this team, the 6'2 senior out of Brooklyn.
Young can't do that. He's done that 2 or 3 times tonight.
Watkins wanted it. Myers didn't get it to him. Took it himself. Back-to-back buckets for Tavon Myers.
I like the way Myers has played this season. He shot 50% from the three, but just his energy. He's a guy. He's the most vocal guy in the gym whenever he walks in. When I've been to practice, been to shoot-arounds, he's always talking, encouraging his teammates. They love him.
Big personality. Zero in blue. Tavon Myers. National Junior College Player of the Year 2 seasons ago. Now just a 2-point game. Texas has led for most of the first half.
Well, here's where West Virginia is at their best. The transition three by Jones is no good. And when you can get a guard rebounding, you can initiate the break that much quicker because there's no outlet to exchange. Rude Olson was a big proponent of that on the teams that I played on. Always emphasizing to me or Mike Bibby or Jason Terry, Damon Stoudemire, if you can get the rebound, that way we can just start the fast break right away, and that was a perfect example.
Allen at the line. Knocks it down, give him 7 on the afternoon. Big Monday doubleheader coming up on ESPN. We start in the ACC, number 11 North Carolina hosting Syracuse at 7. Then at 9, more Big 12 action as Iowa State hosts number 2 Kansas.
About Oklahoma State giving the Jayhawks all they could handle at Allen Fieldhouse today.
Kansas pulled away late, but you're right. Brad Underwood's club looked like they were going to snap that now 49-game winning streak for Kansas at Fog Allen Fieldhouse. West is good.
Yeah, and that's what he does best. He's a Cincinnati native, but he finished his high school career at Miller Grove. Played for a buddy of mine, Charmin White. But Lamont West is going to be like the next guy, the Jonathan Holton or Nathan Adrian next year, that front of that press as a stretch four.
Coming up on 5.5 to go. Texas has led through most of the first half, but they're only leading by 1 now. Allen, no. Claire follows. Shaq Claire has 6 points. And Texas is doing some work on the interior.
Well, that was a great job by Allen. Even though he missed the shot, he drew the second defender, which freed up Claire.
Combined 14 points for the Longhorns big men so far.
Well, if you watch Jared Allen, look at the patience in the post, has the size advantage, and Kanate is a shot blocker. See, he goes up, gets a piece of it, and Shaq Claire there to clean it up.
Tavon Myers at the line. 74% free throw shooter this season, averaging 7.8 points a game.
I like the fact that Myers stuck around this year because he was kind of caught in a numbers game last year. When you have Jayshon Page, who was the best 6th man in the league, Tariq Phillip, who had an excellent year, played off the bench. So you already had 2 guards coming off the bench, and you're playing behind Miles and Carter, the 2 starters. But he's one of the harder workers on the team. We talked about the energy that he brings, and nothing but positivity this year for that young man.
When you talk about no faint praise, Bob Huggins says he might be the fastest guy on this West Virginia team. That's saying something. Myers has scored 7 of the last 10 points for the Mountaineers. And they are down by 1, closing in on 5 minutes to go in the first.
One key that Texas has done well in breaking this pressure is that they've had Eric Davis or another guard as the inbounder against the press. And when they've broken it, they've gone right back to Davis. Look at that finish.
Great
right
take
there
by Jones. been a good first half for Andrew Jones, the 6'4 freshman out of Houston.
Jones was a big-time recruit, a big-time get for Shaka Smart and this Longhorn team. Playing a little bit out of position this year, but you see if you just put the ball in the hand in his hands and let him play, he can make some plays.
Myers off the mark. West Virginia settling for threes and really struggling from beyond the arc.
Well, Andrew Jones, one of the most athletic guys on this team. Great job by Shaq Clair to find him on the weak side. And I love the jump stop in the lane because that gives you so much more body control. So many times guys like to go in just off of 1 foot. And when you go off of 1 foot, either you can get off balance or you're automatically going to be stuck in the air. If you go off the jump stop, you can pump fake, draw contact, and get to the rim.
Done a fair share of coaching in your day. And those are the fundamentals that not a lot of these youngsters coming into college really focus on.
I actually got to coach against Shaka Smart this summer.
How'd that go for you?
It actually went really well.
Yeah.
So he was the head coach of the USA under 18
right.
team, and I was an assistant coach on our USA under 17 team, and we had coinciding training camps. And the first day of the 18 team, our 17 coach, Don Showalter, one of the best in the business, he lets the assistants coach a lot during the practice and the scrimmages. So the first day, Shaka Smart's under 18 group that included Jared Allen and Banks and some high-level recruits, they kicked our butt. The next day, though, came back and went 1-1 against Shaka Smart in full scrimmages.
Going 500 against him is not a bad number.
Yeah, mostly credit to the players, not much of what I did.
Here's Phillip. Knocks it down. That's not something we've seen a lot of this afternoon. A three-pointer by a West Virginia Mountaineer. Tariq Phillip has 5. Just the third three-pointer for the Mountaineers this afternoon in 10 attempts.
We got the mismatch with Allen down low on Phillip. Now they switch. Still, he's too good. Look at Allen working the post. They're going to get a foul.
And it's going to go on Lamont West, number 15 for West Virginia. That's the 10th team foul on the Mountaineers.
Well, look at the big fella, Jared Allen. He's working. He wants that basketball. And the Longhorns going to work here in the first half.
And grow. Instead of focusing on insurance or investments alone, we bring them together into one whole picture. At Northwestern Mutual, we help you live life differently.
Inconsciente, a été transportée à l'hôpital.
Aí, Pedro, preciso de você na caixa. Davi, ajuda ele.
Mas eu vou dizer, mas ele não já, não é?
Texas up 229-27 over 10th-ranked West Virginia. Their largest lead of the game has been 7, and they've been doing most of their damage, Miles, inside.
Yeah, the two big guys have really taken advantage of their size for the Longhorns. Jared Allen, Shaq Clair, 14 points in between them, 5 for 6 from the field. And here, right here, look at Allen, the big pass, interior passing against the pressure. They've also done a great job in helping against the press. And Shaka Smart, a big emphasis yesterday in called eating the passes. And when he was saying that, what he meant is for the big guys, when the guards are getting trapped, to come back and meet the pass and eat that pass every time so that the West Virginia interceptors can't put their hands on it.
Allen's at the line. He's 4 for 4 this afternoon so far from the stripe. Texas is a perfect 8 for 8 as a team from the free throw line.
Talking to Coach Smart yesterday at practice, he said one of the biggest adjustments that he's seen over the years for young big guys is the physical contact and people getting their hands on the basketball and being able to play through that your freshman and sophomore years in college. And Jared Allen doing an excellent job of that today.
He came in leading this team in turnovers with 44. He has one this afternoon, but other than that, it's been a sterling first half for number 31 in white, Jared Allen.
Well, how about 6 for 6 from the foul line also? For a guy that shoots 55%.
Back to a 4-point lead for the Longhorns. 3.5 to go. Good hands by Davis. Knocks it out of bounds. 7 on the shot clock for West Virginia. who, after a really cold start, Miles, 4 for their last 7 from the field. What's changed for them?
Well, they've knocked down a couple open three-point shots. That's helped soften up the defense. But right now, if you're against this zone, you got to get some penetration into the paint.
Good hands by Young. Carter comes up with it and knocks it down in the paint. First 2 of the afternoon for Javon Carter, who had a monster night last time out against Baylor. 17 points, 7 dimes, and 5 steals against the Bears.
Maybe his best effort overall in a Mountaineer uniform. Just controlled the whole game for West Virginia as they pulled the upset.
Look at the big man, Claire, bringing it almost all the way to the midcourt line. And here's the trap at half court.
Smart.
A smart play.
Love that he called the timeout. Didn't panic.
2:48 to go. A well-used timeout by the Longhorns, showing poise in the first half. This afternoon, with another win at Fog Allen Fieldhouse, 87-80. Frank Mason going 20-plus yet again. Where do you think he falls in line in terms of National Player of the Year?
I think him and Josh Hart are 1 and 1A right now. And I like Josh Hart a little bit more, but Frank Mason, God, he's been a stud. He's so good. Both ends of the floor he plays, he's finding a great balance between scoring and passing.
5 on the shot clock. Davis going to have to force it. And a good defensive possession by the Mountaineers with 2:24 to go. Phillip, close range, can't get it to go. Offensive rebound from Watkins. And Brandon Watkins has his first bucket of the afternoon.
Watkins has been such a bonus for this team. He actually took about 6 weeks off this summer to just decide if he was going to continue playing basketball. He's had 2 ACL surgeries. Wasn't playing at the level that he expects himself to play at. But, man, he's been a tremendous contributor throughout the season.
And now tied at 31, West Virginia with a bucket takes the lead. There's a 2, and West Virginia puts themselves on top, 33-31. Their first lead since the 16-19 mark of the first half. And here comes West Virginia. And this is what they come on you.
It's relentless. It's nonstop. You handle it for the first 18 minutes of the half very well. But now they just stay with you, and they bring it to you in waves. And the physicality, and maybe there was a foul underneath the hoop there as Davis went up, but now you have the transition opportunity. You're a little bit slower getting back than you were in the first 6 or 7 minutes, and then the nice finish from Daxter Miles.
Daxter Miles with 5, Javon Carter with 4. The guards are starting to really impose their will. Coming up at halftime, Doug Kazarian, Seth Greenberg, and the Fonz, Lafonso Ellis, will be by with the Land Rover Halftime Report. Big day college hoops as usual, as we are getting into the real teeth of conference play right now. What's jumped out at you in terms of the Big 12, what we've seen so far, Miles?
Well, I think it's a strong lead from top to bottom, the improvement of TCU. Oklahoma State is a better team despite what their record shows.
0-5 now, but they have been in just about every game.
Yeah, Chris Beard and what he's doing at Texas Tech with that team. They beat the Mountaineers last week. It's a fun league night in and night out. There wasn't high expectations in Manhattan, Kansas, but Bruce Weber's doing an excellent job.
Baylor's in Manhattan today, taking on K-State.
Worst case scenario right there. Shaq Claire, I mean, you can't dribble across half court and just pick it up in the corner.
And right now, Shaka Smart's team is in a bad stretch. Another turnover, and West Virginia's on an 8-0 run to grab a stranglehold on this game by 4. 9 Texas turnovers this half.
Remember, West Virginia making this run with 2 of their best players on the floor, off the floor, Ahmad and Adrian.
Here's Konate. Sagava Konate has his first bucket of the game, and he was suffering for some of the same stomach flu that Nathan Adrian had earlier the week.
He's going to be such a good player for Bob Huggins.
And you see Bob Huggins with Don Daly, his nemesis, right in front of him saying, What are you doing?
I'll let you say it.
Well, Bob Huggins has reserved the right after 35 years as a head coach to voice his opinion or two or three.
And he does. Snoop Roach at the line. I think one of the best nicknames in college basketball. Got the nickname from the neighborhood kids that he grew up with in Houston, Texas. Him and his dad were Snoopy and Linus.
Yeah, big time Peanuts fan.
Yeah, now it's shortened to Snoop. I wonder if his dad is still called Linus though around the neighborhood.
I don't know. As long as he's not carrying a blanket around. First missed free throw of the afternoon for Texas. And Roach missed them both. 8 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. West Virginia's trailed for most of this game, but they are on a 10-0 run and have taken a 6-point lead over Texas. Miles.
Travel.
Texas. An unforced error by the Mountaineers. That's their 8th turnover this afternoon. And there's a steal off the inbounds. Myers converts it into two.
And they don't even hold for the last shot. They just go and attack. You gotta love the way West Virginia plays.
7 seconds left. Last shot time for the Longhorns. Three to shoot. Roach does. Knocks it down. That's a big bucket to close the half after West Virginia went on a big run to blitz the Longhorns and take a 5-point lead into halftime, 39-34 West Virginia. They're going to look at that last shot at the scores table and it looked good from our vantage point. They only know one way to play West Virginia. Time doesn't matter. They take a 5-point lead into the break. When we come back, it's the Land Rover Halftime Report. Player in the Final Four, Miles Simon. I am Rich Hollenberg. We are in Austin, Texas, and we're set for the second half of number 10 West Virginia and the Texas Longhorns. West Virginia with a 39-34 lead to start the second half. Miles, how has Texas kept this game close?
Well, they played with a lot of composure and intensity to start this basketball game. They came out firing on all cylinders. They attacked the press, took care of the ball, and when they did turn it over, most of them were dead ball turnovers. I believe 5 or 6 of them were either charges or balls that they just lost out of bounds, and then that made West Virginia set up in the half court.
West Virginia got hot late in the half. They made 10 of their last 12 shots, and that staked them to this 5-point lead.
And that's three on Adrian.
And that's immediately a foul on Adrian. He'll go to the bench with 3 fouls. Texas has led for 12 minutes and 42 seconds of the first half, but find themselves down by 5. Nathan Adrian played only 5 minutes in the first half.
And actually on that inbounds, Eric Davis Jr. got away with the travel. He moved 3 or 4 feet, and the ref is telling him he needs to stay stationary. But to me, if you're the ref and you knew that he moved on the first time, make the call that you're supposed to make.
West Virginia's defense, first in the nation in steals, first in the nation in turnovers forced, but the young Longhorns have really handled themselves at very least adequately so far.
Well, I want to get Jared Allen the ball here against Nathan Adrian.
Here's Jones. Had a couple threes in the first half, missed his first attempt in the second half. Carter for Ahmad. Tried to force it inside to Watkins off his hands and out of bounds. And that's the 9th West Virginia turnover.
Mountaineers just not as sharp or as crisp as they were Tuesday night.
You said it at the top of our telecast, Miles. How is West Virginia going to have an answer for such an important and nation recognizing win against the number 1 team in the nation last Tuesday against Baylor? Adrian with those 3 fouls. Blocked by Allen, and they'll get him for the foul.
Well, so many times West Virginia, sometimes their best offense is just put it up on the glass and then send 2 or 3 guys after it to go get it. Jared Allen did a great job of contesting the first layup, but they couldn't clean up the glass, and now Issa Ahmad going to the foul line. Issa Ahmad is a guy that Coach Huggins is so high on. Wants him to play with a little bit higher motor on a more consistent basis. So I think he's grown on the defensive end this year, and I think he's really just a consistent three-point shot away from being an elite player in this league. He has such great size. He can put the ball on the floor. He's an excellent rebounder.
Ahmad now has 4 points, 18:55 to go, and it's a four-point West Virginia lead. And a whistle. And there's a turnover. And you see Shaka Smart trying to communicate with his club. He's got to do it from almost 94 feet away, though. So now here are the Mountaineers under their own basket.
And here's, if you're Texas, in these first 4 or 5 minutes of the half, you got to stay within striking distance.
Watkins, baseline, no. Jones had to climb over Adrian, but they're going to get Adrian for the foul. And that's four on the senior big man. Oh, they give the foul to Daxter Miles Jr. instead. Maybe that look of disbelief on Nathan Adrian's face helped him out. And now Miles will check out for Bob Huggins, and Lamont West will come in. And they decide to take Adrian out instead.
Yeah, I was going to say, that was going to be a very odd lineup if they had taken Daxter Miles out. There would have only been one guard in the game.
And Roach called for the armbar.
Let's see that. I think Daxter Miles might have sold that with the head jerk. Nothing, nothing, nothing. Oh. He sold it.
14 turnover.
You know what? But officials all over the country fall for it nearly every game. And if they're going to continue to fall for it, players are going to continue to act and flop and sell it.
He's going to get whiplash if he does that again.
This is their little triangle action where they get the three big guys in a traveling violation.
Well, Issa Ahmad's certainly been kept in check, the leading scorer on this Mountaineers club, averaging 12.6 a game, only has four right now. Can Texas solve this West Virginia press in the second half? Sometimes when you're trailing by just four, it feels like 40 against West Virginia.
Got to go inside. Claire's trying to work. Good job by Ahmad moving his feet.
Claire, the lob, Allen the finish.
Credit to Shaq Claire for just continuing to work and not give up on the possession and then delivering a beautiful post-to-post pass.
That's a dozen for the freshman Allen. Carter, baseline, too strong. Claire, the rebound.
Daxter Miles has to shoot that shot.
Texas a chance to tie or take the lead. And Jones, aggressive to the hole, will go to the line.
Well, Shaq Claire couldn't get the ball on the post, and he was working. He popped out, finds it, and Lamont West commits too early. Why are you going to go to contest Shaq Claire at 15 feet? Let Shaq Claire come to you, and that frees up the lob for Jared Allen.
Shaq Claire averaging 7 points, 5 boards a game, but Shaka Smart says about his big man, when he plays well, we play well. Why is that?
Well, because he gives them a presence on the inside, and you know that his energy is good, he's rebounding, and his activity is at a high level. And that's kind of infectious as one of the only upperclassmen that's playing right now for the Longhorns.
Now Claire will go to the bench for a breather. And Andrew Jones will be at the line with the second free throw.
Very unique foul shot style. The step in behind the back. But it works.
That's 9 points for Andrew Jones, who averages 9.6 a game. Javon Myers had a good first half. Loose ball. Who wants it? Allen comes away with it. And a chance to take the lead for the Longhorns. Strong take again by Andrew Jones. Second time down the floor. The freshman has gone right at this West Virginia defense.
Well, look at Andrew Jones just attacking. No one's going to stop the basketball for West Virginia. That's going to make Bob Huggins very upset. Two possessions in a row, and Jones going right to the rim. Listening to Coach Larry Harrison, assistant coach for Bob Huggins, he's telling Tariq Phillip to tell everybody, you're just jogging back. We got to sprint, get set up in our half-court defense.
And you mentioned Larry Harrison. He's the top recruiter for this West Virginia club. And they recruit a different kind of cat. They don't go after blue chippers. They go after players who fit the mold of this West Virginia team. Texas back on top by one. The foul at the rim by Banks will send West Virginia to the line.
West Virginia would be in a bad spot without Tavon Myers today. The energy he brought in the first half, his scoring, 9 points there, the penetration against the man-to-man defense, and the beautiful drop-off to Kanate.
Here's Sagaba Kanate, just a freshman, had 13 points against TCU and has three this afternoon now against these Longhorns.
Kanate originally from Mali, went to high school in Pennsylvania. Only Pitt and West Virginia were the only schools that really were going after Kanate, but he's going to be an excellent player in this league for the next few years.
He not only hasn't played organized basketball for a long time, he's only been in the United States for a couple of years now. He ties the game up with the free throw, 41 apiece, 16:45 to go. Rich Hollenberg, Miles Simon, Big 12 Saturday here on ESPN2. And a traveling violation called on Andrew Jones.
See right there, this is the difference in that Texas team. When you get in the half court, too much dribbling there by Kerwin Roach. No true point guard on the roster. Big decision coming on Monday as far as the recruiting. Another turnover by West Virginia. Very sloppy second half, but one of the best point guards in the country, Matt Coleman, is going to decide between Texas and Duke. And if you put Matt Coleman on this roster right now, and I've got to work with Matt Coleman through some Nike basketball camps, he's a special passer who can set the table for anyone. And with this young roster, and you allow them to mature and get Kerwin Roach and Andrew Jones off the ball next year, huge decision on Monday.
It'll be at halftime of the HoopHall Classic on ESPNU. That starts at 11 a.m. Paul Biancardi telling us Matt Coleman is a consensus top five point guard coming out of high school. Myers kicks it out.
Good recovery defensively.
Transition defense for the Horns. And Roach comes away with it. Chance for Texas to get back on top. Good decision. And the shot goes down. First bucket of the game for Jacob Young. He has five. And the Horns are up by three.
Well, amazing what happens when you just make the simple play. You come down under control. You spot up. Catch and shoot. And you have the lead.
Offense has led to a more energized look on the defensive end for Texas. 10 on the shot clock for West Virginia. And the turnover. Young might have gotten away with a bunny hop there. Roach. Timeout, West Virginia.
Well, now it's this young Longhorn team getting out in transition. The easy pass, the knockdown three by Young. And then one more time for good measure. You jump, I make you pay at the rim. Longhorns by five.
Texas looking for their biggest win by far this season. 46-41, they're up on 10th-ranked West Virginia with 15:04 to go. Miles Simon Shaka talks so much about the word poise with this young team. What have they shown you so far in this contest against West Virginia?
Well, they've shown me a ton of composure, and that this is a team that is as close to getting better. And they're improving on a daily basis. Even though they're so young, they continue to fight and battle and scrap. They follow the game plan, listen to their coach, and continue to learn, and it's paying off today.
I guess with just 5 minutes gone by in the second half, the big question is, can they finish? Three of their four Big 12 games have been decided by 3 points. They've lost four of their last five by an average of 4 points. So they're in games, they just don't know how to close. We have a timeout on the floor with 14:49 to go. The locals in Austin like what they see so far. Their team's up 5. At Waco on ESPN2, and they follow that up by facing Kansas next Saturday, like in the Big 12. Right?
Yeah, and that's every game, every week in the Big 12 is a tough challenge. And the key for this Texas team, concentrate on this game.
Right.
Don't look ahead. And try to hold serve on your home court and see what happens when you go on the road next week.
Baylor up right now on the road themselves against 25th-ranked Kansas State. It is a gauntlet in the Big 12.
Four-guard lineup in for Texas.
And the ball goes off Meyer's hands out of bounds. That's another turnover for the Mountaineers.
Coach Huggins so upset. Just careless with the basketball. Plays that should be a lot easier for West Virginia are not being made.
Kerwin Roach controlling the point. And the foul's going to be called on Miles. Miles got a little taste of his own medicine there. And I don't mean you, I mean Daxter Miles. 5 points, 3 fouls for number 4 in blue, the 6'3 junior out of famed Dunbar High in Baltimore. That school has turned out its fair share of basketball studs.
Well, with this four-guard lineup, and you see just more of a spread offense, they're going to try to drive and kick as much as possible.
Inside, Claire, no. It's been a strong point of the Longhorns this afternoon, their interior offense. Carter baseline, and most coaches will tell you, Miles, nothing good happens when you take a baseline. 15 turnovers for West Virginia. They wave off the bucket as much as the fans wanted it, and Shaq Claire will go to the line.
What a break for West Virginia there. This is a heck of a pass by Jones, the pump fake, and they're calling the foul right there.
So no and one opportunity for the Longhorns.
16 foul on West Virginia. Shaka Smart's Texas Longhorns, undermanned, undersized, up 5 on 10th ranked West Virginia with 13:44 to go. So I digress. No free throws for Claire, but it'll be ball under their own basket. What does Shaka Smart like to do in these type of OB situations?
Well, I think they want to go right back inside, try to get the ball to Claire or Allen once they get into their half-court set. I would go right at Adrian.
Adrian with 3 fouls back in the game. Here's Claire.
Travel.
And I was going to say he got away with the travel, but Don Daly caught it. Good forecasting on your part, partner. They went right inside where they had so much success in the first half. West Virginia looking to silence this Longhorns crowd. 4 turnovers on their last 5 possessions for the Mountaineers. Myers pulls up, knocks it down.
Again, coming through when they need him the most. Team struggling on the offensive end, having to set up in the half court. Tavon Myers with the smooth pull-up.
His career high is 15. Tavon Myers already has 11 today. Claire. The baby hook from Shaq Claire. First bucket of the second half, he has 8.
Even the between the legs on that possession right there. But the patience of Shaq Claire to set all that up.
4 for 5 from the field for the big man. Skip pass. Miles. No. That's something Shaka Smart was warning his kids against. The skip pass. Here's a turnover. And Adrian converts at the other end. Just 6 points for Nathan Adrian, averaging 10.7 a game, but he's been saddled with foul trouble this contest. And now under 12 to go. We have ourselves a one possession ball game. Allen spins and hits.
That's a heck of a play by Jared Allen. The double team came when he first accepted the pass. He almost traveled, but composed himself, gathered, and scored.
Allen off his hands, but it's going to be Texas basketball.
Well, Jared Allen, one of the most skilled big men in all of college basketball. The composure, the up fake, the footwork, and the finish.
That loss, of course, came at the hands of number 10 West Virginia, who find themselves in trouble, if not on the ropes, on the road in the Big 12. A 50-45 lead for the Longhorns against these Mountaineers. Jones, aggressive, but blocked by Macon. And here comes Carter. Macon gets it back at the other end. It'll stay West Virginia basketball.
That was a heck of a play by Elijah Macon. To continue to track that basketball and then play it without fouling and block it off the glass and keep it in play.
End-to-end play from number 45 in blue, Elijah Macon. Adrian.
Presence of Jared Allen right there. Shut off two shot opportunities.
Phillip knocks it down. Ooh. Right in Jones's face.
That's tough.
7 points for Tariq Phillip.
Phillip coming off an excellent game, 11 points against Baylor on Tuesday. Guy that can create his own shot. Was a spark plug off the bench all season. Him and Jayshon Page were just a two-man terror team last season for the Mountaineers.
This is year three of what they call Press Virginia in Morgantown. Every year they've gotten better, but right now, hot shooting Texas is shooting them down. Andrew Jones with his third triple of the day.
Well, that's a heck of a pass, and we talked about it earlier. Andrew Jones much more comfortable off the ball when he doesn't have to think about making decisions.
And Myers with the jump shot, but he's fouled by Davis.
Jones
Tavon has, Myers will go to the line.
Jones has such a beautiful stroke, man. Perfect form. This is an excellent pass. He absorbs the double team. Beautiful skip pass, but he shoots it with the seams, which helps you get nice rotation and soft touch on your shot.
You talk about that like you know a little thing about shooting.
I made a few in my day. I wasn't a great shooter in college, though, actually. I was just okay.
How about this Longhorn offense? Came in shooting just 44% from the field. That's second to last in the Big 12. But today, against maybe the best defense in all of college basketball, they're 53% from the field. Why is that, Miles?
Well, they're getting good shots. The times that they aren't turning it over, they're really sharing the basketball. They're moving it. They have played inside out for the most part.
Myers goes 2 for 2. He has a Baker's dozen. 13 to lead these West Virginia Mountaineers. But the Mountaineers find themselves still down by 4. Jones! Carter. End to end we go with nothing to show for it. Phillip and one.
They don't stop. They keep coming at you. They kept the ball alive on the offensive glass. Tariq Phillip splits the defenders. Jones is just late on the rotation, puts his hip into Tariq Phillip, and then the beautiful finish on the floater. Rich, this is the part of the game where Texas has to be most careful, and this happened to Baylor the other night when it got out of hand. 12, 11, 10 minutes left in the second half is where the waves of pressure really start to wear on your team, and this is it. We explained it's a young backcourt So really now they have to stay composed. Shaka Smart might need to use his timeouts to continue, if they get in trouble against the pressure, get his players some rest so they can finish the game at a high level.
In your playing days at Arizona, did you ever face any team as close to this as what we're seeing?
The one I remember is playing at Arkansas at Bud Walton Arena in the preseason NIT, the second round, and that was when they had the 40 minutes of hell and Nolan Richardson's teams in 1995. But we were able to pull off a win on the road.
There's the turnover forced by the Mountaineers' pressure. Good hands and another deflection. And it leads to points. Phillip again. And you mentioned Shaka Smart's going to have to use timeouts. He did right there. 9:31 to go, and West Virginia climbs back on top, 54-53.
Well, they get the steal in the half court, and Tariq Phillip has been an absolute monster in the last couple minutes with the pull-up jumper, getting to the rim, active on the defensive end. He has some of the best hands on this team. Remember, West Virginia is one of only two teams in the country that has five guys with 20 or more steals, Tariq Phillip being one of those guys.
And Tariq Phillip knows what it's like to have success against the Texas team. Last year, albeit in a loss, Phillip went for 19 against these Longhorns. Today, he has 12, and he puts the Mountaineers back on top. Big Monday doubleheader on ESPN coming up in a couple of days. We start in the ACC, number 11, North Carolina, hosting Syracuse at 7 Eastern. Then at 9, it's Big 12 action as Iowa State hosts number 2 Kansas, who got by Oklahoma State inside Fog Allen Fieldhouse right before this game started. Both games available on the ESPN app and watch ESPN. And interesting to note that Syracuse and Texas, both top 25 teams in the preseason and both struggling mightily when the regular season starts. That's the seventh team foul. It's going to go on Myers.
Texas in the bonus. 1-1
for Kerwin Roach, the 6'4 sophomore. Missed his first two free throw attempts this afternoon.
Roach, actually one of the best athletes in all of college basketball. His back-to-back state titles in the triple jump. Went over 50 feet in high school.
Nice touch on that one. Gives Roach 8 for the game. He averages 11.3 coming in. Part of the Big 12 all-newcomer team 1 year ago as a freshman. A lot more being asked of the sophomore this year. 2 for 2 for Roach. Gives him 9 and cuts the West Virginia lead to a single point.
Rich, you have to remember last year for Roach and Davis, they really played off of Felix and Taylor and those guys' success. So those guys were a little bit deeper in the scouting report last year. Now Davis and Roach, you're at the top of the scouting report and seeing the best defenders from every team. So their roles have obviously completely changed.
Carter.
Tough finish.
Puts West Virginia back on top. First bucket of the second half for Javon Carter. And here's Press Virginia coming right at you.
Got to run the baseline.
Nine minutes to go. This is a West Virginia team that's number one in the nation in margin of victory. They beat teams by 28 points on average. Right now, they're only up a single point. Allen, surrounded by Mountaineers. Three to shoot. Jones does. Air ball. And that's a shot clock violation.
That's a great defensive possession. Move their feet, closed out, shut off the drive by Jared Allen. Contested shot, shot clock violation. That's more like the Mountaineers that you're used to seeing.
Bob Huggins has been around the block a time or two. He said to us when we asked him about Texas, the first thing he said, they're really talented.
Yeah. Huggins, such a great teacher of the game.
Number 10, West Virginia. Getting all they bargained for in Austin.
1-3-1 prep, 1-3-1 half-court trap.
Good passing by the Mountaineers, 10 on the shot clock. And a foul with 8 seconds on the shot clock, and now West Virginia will go to the line shooting 1-1. That's 3 fouls on Roach, 3 fouls on Andrew Jones. And both are still on the floor for Shaka Smart.
One thing why this West Virginia team can have so much success, not only in the Big 12, but I feel in the NCAA tournament, is days like today, is Issa Ahmad struggling from the field, turning the ball over, Nathan Adrian, one of your leading scorers, in a little bit of foul trouble, haven't been sharp. But you can bring guys like Myers and Phillip off the bench. Your defense can always pick you up and carry you for long stretches.
Two years ago, his first season instilling this press, they finished 13-19 in their first year in the Big 12. Then they lost in the NIT first round in their second year. They've had so much success the last 2 years, though, instilling this press. But then, of course, you remember back to round one, NCAA tournament, Brooklyn, New York, and Stephen F. Austin upsets them. What's going to prevent this West Virginia team from suffering that same fate?
Well, it's going to depend on if the team can handle the ball and take care of it against them in a one-and-done scenario. They have to force turnovers. That's the best way they create offense or get to the offensive glass. Stephen F. Austin did a great job of controlling that basketball game. Coach Huggins said it to us, say teams that play slow and control the pace, they give us trouble.
Roach. The foul by Claire. Jack Claire in double digits with 10. Pick and roll. Here's Adrian in the corner. 5 on the shot clock. Miles right down
quick.
Central Ave.
Ooh, he's quick. Just a little hesitation and go. The burst off the first step. Love it from Daxter Miles.
At 22 against TCU. 22 at Oklahoma State. Daxter Miles only has 7 today. But he stakes West Virginia to a 3-point lead. Jones tries for 3 and knocks it down.
Man.
3-pointer of the game for Andrew Jones.
Man, he's going to be such a big-time player in this league. Put a point guard alongside of Andrew Jones, and he's going to have a lot of success.
Tied at 60 in Austin. Coming up on 6.5 to go. Miles around and out. Inside. A little too strong from Claire off the window. Timeout on the floor. 6:21 to go. West Virginia on upset alert in Austin. Tied at 60. Now it's time for Getting More, brought to you by Nature Made Gummies. Miles.
Well, Andrew Jones has been an absolute stud, and the one adjustment he's had today is he's played more off the ball. He's felt very comfortable and in rhythm, knocking down 3-point shots, 4-for-8 from behind the arc, attacks when necessary, getting all the way to the rim, absorbing some contact there. And then when your confidence is high, you feel that everything's going to go. 17 points for the freshman off the bench today.
Something about playing against pressure defenses suits well for Andrew Jones. He had a career best 17 against Arkansas earlier this year. He's tied that career best against West Virginia. 17 tonight, 4-of-8 from 3. And he's a big reason why this game is tied. Jared Allen has 14, Shaq Claire has 10. West Virginia has not been able to turn over the Longhorns like they anticipated. And Roach just throws it away. Miscommunication between Roach and his freshman teammate Jones.
Well, they tried to go to Jared Allen off that after timeout, the ATO. He wasn't open. But you have to do a great job, a better job of creating a lead right there and going attacking the pass.
Now all of a sudden we've been praising Texas for keeping the turnovers down. 6 minutes left and they have 18.
But again, about half of those are dead ball turnovers. No chance to run for the Mountaineers.
Myers, blocked by Claire. Loose ball. Adrian comes away with it.
Only seven on the clock.
And Javon Carter will go to the line.
Personal foul number one on Jones.
That's the fourth foul on Jones. With 5:56 to go, put your coaching hat on. Do you keep Jones in the game right now?
Yeah, I keep him in right now. And you give this chance, this young man, he has to learn to play with foul trouble. He's been your best perimeter player today, knocking down shots. You keep him in there, have him play smart. Maybe you go back to the zone to maybe hide him a little bit.
And they've had success with that zone against West Virginia today. Carter 1-for-2, giving him 7 and giving the Mountaineers a 1-point lead.
And also, there's not many other options to go to on the bench.
That's right. Not only is Tevin Mack suspended from the team, but Kendall Yancey, a senior, is also out for an indefinite amount of time with a foot injury.
Five seconds. Got the timeout.
And now Texas using their last timeout with 5:39 to go in a 1-point game. That might come back to haunt them. Well, coming up tonight at 11 Eastern on ESPN, be sure to tune in to SportsCenter at night. Kevin Connors and Nicole Briscoe will take you through a very busy Saturday of sports, including the NFL playoffs, previews of tomorrow's divisional games, and everything else from a packed Saturday. SportsCenter at night on ESPN, as well as streaming live on the ESPN app and watch ESPN. Texas has certainly had these Mountaineers numbers in the last couple of seasons. They've taken 5 of the last 6, including winning both games last year. West Virginia was ranked 6th the first time they met, and Texas beat them 56-49. Then they were ranked 10th when they came here to Austin, and Texas took them down again, 85-78. But you pointed this out, a much different Texas team. But Shaka Smart obviously has used some of that tape from last year to teach his young kids how to play this year.
Yeah, well, the things that you can show them is that if you play under control, take care of the basketball, that you can have success against West Virginia. They only had 15 total turnovers in those two games last year.
West Virginia shooting just 4-for-16 from three-point range. That's 25%. Texas having maybe its best shooting day of the season, shooting even 50% from the field. Coming up after us, Maryland and Illinois, Big Ten basketball. We still have 5:39 to go here. Rich Hollenberg, Miles Simon. Another tightly contested Big 12 conference contest. Number 10, West Virginia, trying to hang on and get an all-important road win in conference play against Texas. And Jones ill-advised, even with the shot clock winding down.
Shaka didn't like the shot. He wanted, on the isolation, he wanted Jones to just attack and try to get to the rim. And he wanted to try to draw a foul there or another, get an opportunity for an offensive rebound.
Another growth moment opportunity for these young Longhorns. Ten to shoot. Phillip does. High arcing three. Saved by Adrian. But Allen came away with it for Texas. Here's Jones.
That was a foul. Javon Carter clearly grabbed him at half court.
Carter might have got away with one there, but he might get the benefit of the doubt too. Third in the nation in steals. Here he is on the other end. Yes! A rainbow from Javon Carter. Three-point Mountaineers lead, 4.5 to go. Let's go back to that knock call.
Yeah, here's the call. Look at Javon Carter right here. Grabs him by his waist. I mean, that is a clear foul that the officials miss. Carter answers on the other end, makes the jump shot to give him the lead. And then the officials call a foul on Carter again on the press.
Look, a gift horse in the mouth, young man. Here's Roach at the line. Oh. And he missed the front end. Just a 66% free throw shooter, Kerwin Roach. That's another category that this Texas offense struggles in. Myers, too strong. Claire, the rebound.
With the quickness of these West Virginia guards, I'd love to see them try to penetrate more, get to the rim, put some pressure on the defense.
What would you like to see from Texas right now?
Jared Allen in the post.
Claire had it blocked by Konate. And you're right, Allen hasn't gotten a touch in seemingly forever.
That's what I like right there. You put pressure on the defense, you attack, get downhill.
They wave it off, there's a foul on the floor. When we come back, West Virginia will be shooting free throws, up three on the road with 3:52 remaining. Thanks, guys. I love Seth Greenberg making a baseball reference there. Mariano Rivera.
I don't know how many shots Mariano Rivera ever made. I know he pitched and he threw a lot of strikes.
He didn't have
maybe
to
that
shots.
He was the closer or he was the finisher.
Yeah. All he needed was that one pitch. Here's Carter at the line. Front end of the 1-1 is good for Javon Carter in double digits now with 10.
Coach Huggins been so complimentary this week of Javon Carter and his improved play and learning the point guard position over time. He's mostly a combo guard coming out of high school, but has had to play the point guard spot the last two positions, last two seasons.
Carter knocks them both down.
If I'm Texas, when I break the press, if I don't have an open three or a layup, when I get into my half-court set, I got to get Jared Allen to touch against Nathan Adrian.
Five-point West Virginia lead. Their largest of the game is 7. And we're coming up on 3.5 to go. Jones. Walled up by the Mountaineers defense.
Konate does such a great job. I told you he's the difference maker for this team. Konate's only 6'8", but man, he's explosive athletically. He changed that shot of Jones in the paint.
And that foul's on Andrew Jones, and that'll be it for him. Calling it a day after a spectacular 17-point performance from the youngster.
Well, excellent performance, not only in the offensive end, he was solid defensively. It's a positive going forward for Andrew Jones and something to build on going into next week. I love the fact that he has his arm around.
Yeah, that's a great
right
shot
there.
That's
an excellent bond between coach and player. Not holding his head down that he fouled out.
Myers misses the first. One for two from the line for Myers, 16. That's a new career high for the senior out of Brooklyn. Now Kerwin Roach is going to be asked to handle the point guard duties from the rest of the way out.
And he's going to have to add some perimeter scoring for this team if they're not going to get it to Claire or Allen.
Roach kicks it to Young from the corner. Big three-pointer by Jacob Young.
Great pass and vision from Kerwin Roach.
One possession ball game. Konate can't finish. A three ties it for the Horns. 2:45 to go. Allen. Tough shot from close range.
The decision making by Kerwin Roach on the last two possessions, phenomenal. That's growth at the point guard spot.
Carter.
A lot of guts and toughness in that young man. Proviso East High School, home of Doc Rivers, Michael Finley, Shannon Brown, and Javon Carter.
And Carter commits the foul at the other end. That'll send Kerwin Roach back to the free throw line, where it's been a bit of an adventure for him. He's just 2 for 5 from the stripe this afternoon. Well, Roach 67% as a team, but today they are 15 for 19 from the line. Big reason that they have stuck around all afternoon. Roach gets the Irwin Center touch on that free throw. This to bring him to within one. Got it. They're on their feet in Austin. And a timeout, West Virginia. So Bob Huggins has one remaining. Shaka Smart is out of timeouts. 1:57 to go. Both teams in the double bonus. And possession arrow will go to West Virginia on the next jump ball. Well, if you thought West Virginia was going to roll into Austin and blow out these young Longhorns, guess again, my friend. This one is coming right down to the wire. And for these Texas Longhorns, Miles, this is nothing new for them. They have had the bulk of their games in the Big 12 decided by 3 points. They've lost 4 of their last 5, but those have been by an average of 4 points. Here's another moment to grow for these young Horns.
Yeah, it really is. And you hope that they've learned from those situations, and maybe they can close one of these close games out against one of the best teams in the country. Now, the interesting thing to watch coming out of this timeout, throughout this game, out of timeout, Shaka Smart, when his team is on defense, has changed his defense. So they've been in man-to-man. So does he go zone now or stay with the man-to-man and see what Coach Huggins comes? And they go zone.
Five on the shot clock. Carter.
What a finish.
Woo!
Boy, has he been big the last couple minutes.
Javon Carter.
Just the type of leadership that Coach Huggins was looking for.
5 for 9 from the field now for Carter. He has 13.
They got a mismatch down low with Allen if they can get it to him.
Roach instead, the step back. No. And the foul is going to go on Kanate.
Well, Javon Carter, when they've needed him the most, has stepped up down the stretch. The beautiful drive, and see how he went off 2 feet. The jump stop and the finish right there gave him more body control as he went to the rim.
That's 4 fouls on Sagaba Kanate, sending Jared Allen to the line. He's been quiet in the second half. 6 points early on. They really haven't looked for him in the latter stages here. He misses his first. And that's his first free throw miss of the entire game.
Now,
6 for 6 before that.
Now, interesting that Shaka Smart doesn't put anybody on the foul line. So no offensive rebound opportunity unless West Virginia just falls asleep.
1 for 2 for Allen. He has 17. 2-point game, and now full court pressure from Texas with 1 minute left. Three to shoot. Phillip. Adrian the offensive rebound, but he lost it. And a foul is going to be called.
A
And a lot of times it's not the first shot that hurts you, but the second chance opportunity. West Virginia, one of the best offensive rebounding teams in the country. They get 16 per game. Kanate looks like he got a handle that ball, and then Nathan Adrian hanging around for the long rebound is now going to the line.
Nathan Adrian suffering from the stomach flu earlier this week, saddled with foul trouble this afternoon. That's just 7 points for Nathan Adrian, the senior from Morgantown.
Coach Huggins says this team would be lost without Nathan Adrian, the leadership and toughness that he has showed throughout this season.
Two clutch free throws from the senior puts West Virginia up 4. They get it into Allen, knocked out of bounds by Carter.
Now if you're Texas, there's a lot of time on the clock. It's a two possession game. You're only down 4. Once you get it in, if you can break the pressure, try to attack the rim. You don't need a 3 unless it's on a drive and kick out to an open look. Try to score, try to draw a foul, maybe score with the clock stop, but you definitely want to attack here.
Roach leaves it for Claire. Two-point game and a timeout, West Virginia. Both teams out of timeouts with 26.5 left. While both teams talk it over, let's send it back to the studio and Doug Kazarian. Rich Hollenberg, Miles Simon, timeout on the floor. It's a one-bucket ball game. West Virginia, ranked 10th in the country, coming off a win against number 1 Baylor earlier in the week, looking to escape Austin with a win on the road in the Big 12. Miles, take us inside both huddles right now.
Well, right now for Texas, they're going to set up their full-court pressure. You've seen it the last couple of possessions. Put Jared Allen with his length and size at the front of that press. Try to get a deflection. With 26 and a half seconds left, plenty of time to trap. You don't have to foul right away. If West Virginia breaks it and gets across half court, then you try to find the weakest foul shooters. West Virginia, not a great foul shooting team as a group, only 64% on the season. You monitor, if you're the assistant coaches, who's on the floor and let your guys know who are the weakest foul shooters, so in case they touch the ball, then you go ahead and give that foul. If you're West Virginia, you gotta have a lot of composure. Take your time against this press. You don't have to shoot anymore. You got to be able to make free throws and take care of the basketball to come out with a win.
And we talked earlier about Texas and their close losses. Well, West Virginia only has 2 losses all season, but both of those were by a combined 5 points. They lost by 4 to Temple and by 1 in overtime to Texas Tech. They're on their feet inside the Irwin Center. 26.5 to go. West Virginia up 2 with the ball. Carter escapes, gets across half court before the foul is called.
Carter, a good foul shooter, 75% on the season. He's been clutch down the stretch in the last 2 minutes and giving West Virginia this lead.
Carter came into today averaging 14 points a game in conference play. This first free throw will give him an even 14. Sagaba Kanate comes in for Lamont West.
Now again, same game plan on the offensive end for Texas. Nearly 22 seconds left. Don't need a 3 yet. Plenty of time to attack. Try to score at the rim. Try to get fouled. Break the pressure first.
Roach for 3. Off to the side, and Phillip gets a huge rebound for West Virginia, and they get fouled with 10.3 to go.
The possession before, they ran the same play, the double high ball screen. They got the switch that they wanted. Typical West Virginia defense. They'll switch Adrian out onto the guard, and Roach penetrated, attacked, and dropped it off to Claire for the easy layup. That time got a little bit of separation, but a contested 3. Tough shot for Kerwin Roach.
Now Tariq Phillip with a chance to all but ice this game away for the Mountaineers. Can't do it there.
Missed them both. Under 10 to go. Davis, short. Allen the rebound, and he puts it back, but it's going to be a little too little and a little too late again for the Texas Longhorns. A 19-point effort for Jared Allen. That's a new career high for the freshman. And with 0.7 seconds left, West Virginia will be back at the line, up 74-72 right now.
Well, I know there's no moral victories for Shaka Smart, but it's a team that put a suspension on one of their best players, Tevin Mack, earlier this week. 15 points. The team with the depleted roster comes out and battles and plays one of the top 10 teams in the country to a two-point game into the last second. And I think if you're Bob Huggins, you have to like the resiliency of your team. You don't play your best basketball today, but you're on target for a win, and Bob Huggins is telling Tavon Myers to miss this free throw on purpose, which I think is a very smart move.
Absolutely. Around and out, and that's your ball game. A hard-fought win for West Virginia gives Bob Huggins career win number 806, tying him with Eddie Sutton, the Hall of Famer, for ninth most in NCAA history. West Virginia hangs on. So for Miles Simon, I'm Rich Hollenberg, saying so long from Austin, Texas. Now we send you to Champaign as the Fighting Illini play host to the Terrapins.